Hey everyone, I'm Ali Matu and I'm here with
Josue Cardona.
And we're talking the psychology of video games while playing video games. Actually, one game in particular. Dun 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 dun
da 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 da. Where's your Leia stuff?
It fell apart after the video.
Do you play a lot of video games now?
No.
Did you used to play?
Yeah, I used to play video games all the time until I got to grad school.
I've always tried to have all the consoles.
You want all the consoles. You're like Galacticus.
Yeah.
Consumer of consoles. Most video games now are designed to really capitalize on the psychology of flow. So flow is this whole like state where you're completely engaged in this task. Time is flying by.
Flow is that sweet spot between difficulty and skill. It's a little harder, but I think I can do it.
So it's like when you play the original Mario Brothers, the first level is all about figuring out how the world works, but then as you improve, so does the challenge.
Yep.
If you're really good at a game and I'm not, it's not going to be fun for me if I'm constantly losing, which is why I love Mario Kart. It really balances that out.
But if you play online, it's all about matchmaking.
Yeah.
It monitors how good you are, and then it tries to place you with people who are just as good as you, so it's not that frustrating.
This is why I gave up playing StarCraft. Even with that matchmaking process, I constantly lose against people. It ended up becoming such a frustrating experience, I wasn't experiencing any flow with that.
You want to put the droid where the reticle is?
What's a reticle?
You see those three little lines?
Isn't that called like crosshairs or something?
Could be, yeah. A lot of research around video games have people sit down, play a video game, right, that they've never played before, learn the controls, and then ask them like how they feel. And you'd be very frustrated if you only had 10 or 15 minutes to actually learn how to play a game.
Violent video games do increase aggression, and that's what you're talking about. But aggression is different than violence. There's no link right now with violent video games leading to violence. So that's like engaging in violent acts versus feeling that tension and frustration. The problem that you're talking about too is the ecological validity. Does what happened in a lab actually relate to what happens outside? This is also one of my favorite moments in Star Wars, is speed biking.
No one is gonna take you seriously with that shirt on.
I know. I love Star Trek and Star Wars. You know, I first... Whoa, you're going so fast! Oh my gosh, it's just like the movie. Don't run into a tree. That was why I do not run into a tree.
Oh man. If speeder bikes were real, there would be no skill transfer from you playing a speeder bike here to an actual speeder bike.
Yeah.
And that's one thing that a lot of people don't understand, that even if you're playing a game where you're shooting a gun, whether it's a real gun or a fake gun, it doesn't make you good at shooting a gun.
Yeah.
And that goes across many, many different learning games.
Yeah.
Unless you're actually doing the thing in the correct way, just kind of almost approximating or simulating the thing, doesn't really work.
The argument that people make a lot of times with video games is how engaging they are. And it gets back to that flow element and how much you feel like the character and you feel.
Yeah, and so maybe now with virtual reality, if there are bullets flying past my head, it's very, very different than me looking at it on a screen. Right? The more immersive it gets, maybe. But the truth is that the media that we have, even though it looks realistic, the experience isn't realistic. It's not a very good simulation.
Using the real world is always better than simulation, but for a lot of things that are hard to simulate, like flying, or maybe some type of complex trauma related to combat, virtual reality type of technology coming out of video games is super helpful for that. Darth Vader, Emperor Palpatine, what? You can play as them? That's really cool. The most modern research that we have now on substance abuse, it's not about the physiological reaction. It's avoiding thoughts or emotions or feelings or situations that are hard for you to face. That's why some people go to drugs. But you know, that is the problem across mental health, is avoidance of experiences, avoidance of situations that are hard for you to experience. And for some people, it might take the form of video games. And
you prefer to play Star Wars Battlefront or your favorite video game than deal with whatever else is.
Exactly. That's why you got to look at the function of video games. Why are people engaging in the game? And combine that with impairment? Is it getting in the way of your life?
Yep. You don't want to go to work because you'd rather play.
Yeah.
Or you didn't sleep because you played all night.
We got a good question on Twitter here. I've had moderate anxiety since I was a kid, and playing console games has always helped calm my nerves. Why is that?
It could be a complete distraction.
Yeah.
Right? Because if you are not thinking about the thing that you're afraid of, then you're not afraid.
Yeah.
You're not feeling that feeling. So that could be one.
And that's something that we might recommend for people who have a really hard time regulating their emotions. Video games for some people can be a good stress tolerance. So if you're really, really upset, video games for some people can be a healthy way of making you feel a little bit more calm.
Yep. So many people have a lifestyle or a job where you feel completely stuck. There's no progression.
Yeah.
You know, there's no movement. So you can come home and even, it doesn't matter how simple the game is, most people don't realize this, but they love to play a game because they're actually making progress.
Yeah.
And they move forward a little bit and it does feel really good.
Yeah.
And that feeling really good can offset that anxiety that you were feeling before.
Absolutely. It all gets back to the function. What is the video game doing for you? And for a lot of people, it does lots of different things.
And what is your intention for playing the video game? So if you're using video games as a power-up, right? Something like your one-up mushroom, right? That's very different than using it as a side mission to get away from the main story.
You know? Oh, dude, that's a great analogy. That's a really great analogy.
Yeah.
We want you to finish the game at some point. We want you to achieve the goals that you have in your life. And if you're constantly engaging in side missions and never getting back to the big goal that you have, the main story, you're never going to finish the game. Yeah. What questions do you have about the psychology of video games? How have they impacted your life? Good, bad, and ugly? Let us know in the comments below. I'm at Oli Matu on Twitter. Josue, where can people find more of your work on the internet?
I'm at Josue A. Cardona on Twitter or youtube.com/Josue Cardona.
Be sure to like The Psych Show on Facebook and subscribe on YouTube. May the force be with you and your video games.
The part where she's
cut this part.
Yeah, one of my
remix.